In a previous video, I showed you how to start a view analyzer. In the second video, we will explore the results. Once a view analyzer has done with the analysis, you can see the result in two tabs. The task log provides you with information related to the view analyzer task run itself. You can also see for each analyzed entity the memory consumption, as I have selected this option. The entity tabs contain the details of the view analyzer findings per analyzed entities. It provides you with information that helps you improving your data model. For example, you can check the persisted columns and see which underlying views are persisted. Sometimes, it's a good idea to persist intermediate views if they read data from different sources and combine them. The memory consumption could already be quite high, and the result of the view may have to be stored as intermediate result in the memory. If this view is persisted, then the top views that do also EV calculation can be optimized. It can help also to check the partitions column and see if partitions have been defined for the analyzed view. When you partition your data loads, the data is divided into several batches called partitions. Each partition is retrieved and stored on its own and thus consumes less memory. Check also if your view consumes remote table and which adapter is used to access the table data. Some adapters have limited capabilities. Sometimes it helps to replicate the data. You can display the whole list of results and search for a specific entity, for example. Or you can export the list of results. You can also display the lineage of your data with a dependency graph. You can restart the view analyzer from an underlying view, either from the entity list or from the dependency graph. The analyzer will always start the analyze from the main view, but the persistency simulation will happen only on the selected view, regardless its persistency status. And that's all for today. Thanks for watching!